guys, so welcome back to my channel. You're watching Digital Arwa, where we learn, grow and earn. If you're new to my channel, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and also click the bell icon to get notified whenever I upload a new video. So how should you start a YouTube channel? Your content is increasing like crazy. I have started this channel to make you knowledgeable about digital marketing, blogging and earning money online. So it is a very big competition when you start video marketing and video content. So it can be a little overwhelming. So here I am to help you and guide you how to start a profitable and a best YouTube channel that your audience will love. Now, before you will get into starting a YouTube channel, there are a few questions that you need to ask yourself and write it down. So the first question is, why do you want to start this YouTube channel? Now list down the points, list down at least 3 points why you want to start this YouTube channel. Like for me, I wanted to share my knowledge about digital marketing. The second thing was I wanted to earn side income. And the third thing was it is my passion. So I love sharing knowledge to people about the things that I know. So what are your 3 things for which you want to start a channel? So please write it down so you will remember that whenever you start a YouTube channel, these are my goals. These are the things that I need to keep in mind. The second question that you need to ask is, who is your target audience? My target audience for me is all the digital marketers, all the people who are doing 9-to-5 job and are tired of that job and want to earn a side income. Or people like who just have a passion about digital marketing. So write down your target audience. If you are into fashion or technology, like for tech people, they'll mostly be engineers or people who have great passion in technology or in learning new stuff about the new phones that come out or the new laptops that come out. So that is one thing. Third question that you need to ask yourself is, how can I make it easy for my audience? Like if you want to start a tech channel, then it is like there are 10,000 tech channels on YouTube currently, and I mean more than that. I'm just giving you a example. Like you need to be different, and you need to provide your audience the content in an easy way. Like they need to understand your content and they need to understand you as a person to connect and subscribe to you. So that is one thing. Then the last thing that you need to know is, how will it help you? I am starting this channel because it's my passion, so I feel happy to make videos. Now for that, something will be different for you. Like it can help you learn something, or it can help you earn money, or it can help you in many other different ways. So these 4 questions are important. Like for the first question was, why do you want to start a channel? The second question was, who is your target audience? The third question was, how can I make it easy for my audience? And the 4th question was, how will it help you? So please make sure to list down all the things that you know on pen and paper so that you have a clear vision in mind. I'm going to give you 10 tips as to how to start a YouTube channel and how you can grow exponentially. Selecting a niche. Now to select a niche, you need to keep 3 things in mind, which I also told you in the previous video. If you haven't watched it, please make sure to check out that video. The 3 things are skills, experience and passion. You need to have these 3 things in order to start a YouTube channel. Now selecting a niche can be a tedious task, so please make sure to watch the previous video first before watching this video. I'll mention the link in the description box. The second thing is selecting a catchy name and a slogan. Now I have created my channel name as Digital Arwa because it's quite catchy and it relates to it. Like I talk about digital marketing, earning online, so it relates to it. And it has my name, so my name will become a brand in future if my channel grows exponentially. So make sure if you don't want to select a catchy name, put it, make it simple and keep your own name. But don't keep tough names, don't keep numbers as your channel name, because it will become pretty much difficult for others to remember. So thing that you need to keep in mind is how to learn basic editing skills. You need to have some editing skills in order to upload a video on YouTube. You need to have an intro, you need to have an outro. If you're just starting out, it's okay, you can learn slowly, but make sure you have those things. You need to tell your subscribers to subscribe to your channel. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't, and also you need to tell them to hit the bell icon, so that in every single video, I'm talking about not only one video, but in every single video, you need to interact with your subscribers in order to gain their attention and gain their love. So that is one thing. The fourth thing is the equipments that you use. Everybody doesn't have a high class camera, and everybody doesn't have a DSLR. I myself am shooting on this Samsung phone, so it's okay to shoot videos on a normal phone rather than buying a camera and investing in editing tools. You can, at the beginning, when you don't have a higher budget, you can use the basic things that you have at home. Now if you're watching this video, for sure you're going to have a phone, so you can use that phone to edit videos and upload your videos. If you don't have a laptop, you can edit videos on your phone. So that, please don't make excuses that I don't have a camera, I don't have a laptop to edit videos. So just start now, so you will understand where you are going. The fifth point, you should love what you do. Like if you go and see top YouTubers like Technical Guruji or PewDiePie or T-Series, like they have put so much effort in their YouTube channel. They post videos every single day without fail, and that is not easy. I understand that, but you need to put love and effort. Even if you post two videos every week, you need to have that much of passion, you need to have that much of efforts put in that video to get the love from the subscribers. The sixth thing that we are coming to is being consistent. You need to make a schedule as to when you are going to shoot the videos, when I'm going to edit the videos, and when you're going to upload the videos. And the first thing is telling your subscribers, letting them know beforehand that you're going to upload those videos at this particular time, so they are excited for that video. The seventh thing is interacting with your subscribers. Now, interacting doesn't only mean replying to the comments. Interact with them outside YouTube, like interact with them on Instagram or on Twitter or other social media. You need to interact with them so that they know that you do put that much effort into them and you spend that much of time into them, so that they can give you love back. Now if I upload this video, I won't hit 1 million in one day. So the eighth thing that we are coming to is being patient in every situation. Like if you don't get that many views, if you don't get that many likes, comments, shares, you need to be patient. It will happen eventually, and you need to keep faith, and being consistent is the only solution to it. Thing is making sure you have the right keywords in your description, in your title, in your tags that you use. Make sure that those are the right keywords. You have that YouTube search bar, just type in the video that you're making and you'll have a list of suggestions below it. I'll just mention it here, so you can see, like, they have a list of suggestions, so you can put those suggestions into your keywords or your description or your title to rank your YouTube video higher. And make sure whenever you're writing a title, make the keywords put the keywords in the beginning, so that whenever somebody is searching, your keyword is in the start, so that video will come, that will, you will have a higher preference on YouTube search engine. Thing is, don't be jealous and help and collaborate with people. Being jealous is easy. Like, I see other people's views and subscribers, so I shouldn't get jealous because they have higher number of subscribers and views and I don't have that. So you should have that much of patience. You should help other people and collaborate. Try to collaborate with people who have similar channels as like you have. Like, if I have a fashion channel, I will collaborate with people who are like the ratio matches with my ratio. So I will approach those people via email or via Instagram DMs. So that will help them as well, and that will help you as well. If you like this video, please make sure to subscribe, and I hope you follow all these 10 tips in order to grow your YouTube channel. Thanks for watching. See you next week.